Good morning and welcome once again to The Breakfast. More conversations that we have this morning. It's a day to talk and celebrate the life of Rear Admiral Ndubuisi Kanu, a former Lagos State Governor between 1977 and 1978. We've invited to join us a close friend and ally of Ndubuisi Kanu, Mr. Ayodele Adewale, the former chairman Amuod of in local government area. Good morning. Thank you for joining us on The Breakfast.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
It was a pleasure. I want you to start because it's, you know, said that you have been a very, very close friend to Ndubuisi Kanu until his death. So I want you to quickly share with us as briefly as possible from your perspective, his life's greatest moments, some things that he would always, you know, from your angle, be remembered for.
Well, once again, thank you for having me, but I would like to correct the statement. I am not a friend. If I call him a friend, that means I've belittled him. I'm more like a son to him, and it gave me a privilege to come very close with him during his lifetime, and I am one of his followers in Adeko. Admiral Kanu, late Admiral Kanu was a wonderful man, was the leader of Nadeko, and was a true believer of democratic ethos. He held strongly all norms of democracy. He advocated for one Nigeria. He believes in Nigeria, and he believes in the rule of law. And he has always demonstrated this while he was alive, including whenever we had our NADECO meetings or other meetings to talk about the growth of Nigeria, especially when we organize programs to commemorate June 12th. He was a very strong believer of June 12th and in Chief MKO Abiola that if June 12th had been allowed to stay, that Nigeria would have moved forward and many of these quagmires that we face wouldn't have been. And Nigeria would have taken its position as one of the giants in Africa, if not the giant of Africa, but one of the giants in the world.
Fantastic. Now, he was very active in Nadeco. You know, he pushed for, you know, when it came to the election, the June 12th election, 1993, that was annulled. He, you know, pushed for Sani Abacha to step down and, you know, for him to, I'm talking about MKO Abiola, to be recognized as president of Nigeria. Well, we saw all the controversy, the human rights abuse, how he was arrested, taken from Lagos to Port Harcourt, all everything he faced. Well, what's your comment on the fact that several years later, we still have opposition like that from the government in power and opposition or activists who are seeking for, you know, different causes?
I wouldn't call Admiral Kanu an opposition. I would call him a realist. Remember that he was a member of the military council, and before his retirement, he was very active in the military circle and the government circle. And while he was in government as a military officer, he did his best. He did his best, particularly using the rule of law and within the confines of the military law. He never went aboard of reality, knowing fully well that the people come first, the people matter. And when Abacha decided to take the gauntlet of power, he was very frank in speaking truth to power and told him all that needs to be told. And when Abacha refused to listen to the words of wisdom and the words of the elders, he had to engage him, and I use the word cautiously. He engaged him in every matter that confronts the Nigerian state and every matter that concerns the violation of human rights. And that led to his incarceration. And beyond that, he wasn't afraid of death. He wasn't afraid that the Abacha junta would garnish whatever he stood for. He confronted them until democracy was reinstated in Nigeria. Such men are very, very limited now, but we still have them. We still have a lot of them. My prayer is that God forgives his sin, grant him everlasting peace, and may his soul continue to water and propel true democratic system in Nigeria that will guarantee the total rule of law in this country.
All right. You know, I would also like, you know, you to share with us in the time that we have. I hope that we have all the time for the questions that I have to ask. But I want you to also share with us, because this conversation we're having is all about, you know, paying respect to him and letting people understand who he was and, you know, the values that he had. And it's a great thing that you're able to share this much. But I want you to share with us who he was as a person, aside politics, aside governance, aside his views with regards to federalism and all of that. Who was he as a person, as a father and as a friend, Ndubuisi Kanu?
Admiral Kanu was a very simplistic man, very simplistic. You need to be with him. He does not relegate you. All he wants is that you bring to bear, or to actually to the table, what is needed to move any discussion forward. And I've been very privileged to sit around him. And whenever we have our meeting, I was the youngest, or actually I am the youngest amongst them. It's been an age difference of over, between some of them and myself, of over 45 to 50 years. So you can imagine that gap. And beyond that gap, he would listen. Sometimes myself and him would sit alone in his office. We would discuss for several hours. He's fond of picking his paper and Bible. Whenever a discussion starts, the first thing he will do is pick his paper, pick his pen, and he will listen to you with rap attention. He will jot down every point that you bring out, and he will engage you on the basis of your point. And he quickly succumbed to, if I may use the word, humbly superior arguments when he sees that your thoughts are very, very contemporary to the issue on ground. He quickly embraced it and convinced his peers to look towards your direction. He's a very detribalized man. He's a very warmly man. Whenever you go to his home, he settles you in very quickly, asks for what you drink. He wants you to just feel at home, feel free, and he never despises anybody. You should also remember that he is also one of the leaders of the Igbo nation. Yes. I remember a time when a little young lady needed some links to some of the Igbo leaders because she was having a program that concerned the cultural heritage of the Igbo. The first thing that came to my mind quickly was Admiral Kanu. And immediately I called him, come over. We brought the lady, and he gave her all the links that she needed. Even in my political life activity, he would call me that, young man, come. What is going on now in your party? How are you faring? What are your chances? Who do you need us to talk to? And all of that. You know, he's a very open man. He's a very open man. He's an open book. He allowed you to read whatever you want to read in his mind. And he shared thoughts. It's rather saddening that such a person as has departed us. We pray that his family are able to bear this great loss, because it's not easy. And he's a very true father to his children and people around him. I wish you had met him before he left. Is somebody that you want to live forever. And he's a team player. He's a true state man. He was privileged to be the governor of Lagos and Old Imo State. There's hardly any program that you call him to, Admiral Kanu will come. And he's always punctual. He's never late to any program. He is always punctual to your program. Okay. He will sit in his car. As soon as the time is, he walks into your event, and he will sit down at your event till the end of the program. He wouldn't leave.
Great words,
and he stands by his friends.
Indeed.
Stands by everybody.
These are words we all aspire, you know, that people can speak about us long after we're gone,
absolutely,
leaving a good legacy. And talking about the core of his ideals as a pro-democracy activist, we know that he regularly and repeatedly called for a return to true federalism. What comments can you make about that?
Well, these were part of what he spent most of his time, all of his time, doing while he was here in this mundane. And I can also share with you when we were all working for the People's Constitution during the pro-national conference organization platform headed by the late Chief Anthony Enahoro of blessed memories. He had Dr. Bekor and Sonkuti as his vice and Professor Wanesho Ika as his deputy. I was the mobilization officer of PRONACO as of then, and I worked closely, strongly under the late Baba Oni Wide Omojola and Chief Alfred Leary. These people are gone now. We worked very strongly for a people's constitution, and in that constitution, we also created a structure for true federalism, a situation where all federating units will be allowed to play their role as it should be. And of course, the people's police, state police, local government police, and all of these things were strongly debated. And I still have that document. Tomorrow I kept some of those documents, the draft constitution, and all of this. You see, Nigeria strictly and strongly need true federalism. We need restructuring. Restructuring is what can guarantee a coherent security system for us in this country. One, because of our population. Two, because of our cultural attributes and all of that. And four, to strengthen our economy in this country. God has blessed this country so strongly. There is no part of this country that is not richly blessed, including the far north, where you have the Sahara strongly encroaching. God has carefully also placed human beings there to adapt to that situation, and of course, natural resources to cope with. So there's no corner of Nigeria that is deprived. The only thing that we need to do is restructure this country, pay more emphasis on education. If you look at the Arab Emirates now, you see what education, science, and technology have been able to do for them. Dubai is now the destination for tourism. A lot of people are going there. But don't forget that Dubai is a desert land. That is a place where they've been able to grow grass on the desert. That is the work of science. That's the work of technology. And it's spinning their economy. And everybody is very, very blessed in that region. Talk more of Nigeria that has one of the largest deficit of natural and human resource.
Thank you very much.
Our population should be our strength, and our population should be our wealth. So structuring the country appropriately will guarantee us of this
development. All right, we're out of time. Mr. Ayodele Adewale, would like to say thank you for your time.
Thank you.
The biggest part of this conversation still is the life and times of Rear Admiral Ndubisi Kanu. Of course, our condolences to his wife, Gladys Ndubisi Kanu, and of course, all his children. Thank you very much once again for joining us, and rest in peace to him.
Thank you. Admiral Kanu lives on.
Always. All right. Good morning. Thanks once again for staying with us all the way.
Yes,
we have a little bit more coming your way.
Yes, the big story about COVID-19 and vaccination is that somebody really huge in the Christian world has taken that vaccine. So we'll be seeing just how much that would influence, you know, religious leaders globally and in Nigeria in our specific situation, you know, maybe to change their minds on the COVID-19. Is it real? Is it not? You know, the vaccines and all of that. Just stay tuned after this break.